In this video we will take a closer look at self-buff tab in the Adrenaline Bot interface. The settings of this tab determine how your bot and its pets will behave in battle. Use skills, items, or ingame buff to obtain positive effects, switch auras on and off, and under what conditions. The first thing we see is a table that displays a list of skills, items, and ingame buffs, as well as their settings. In the first column the name. In the second various conditions. In the third the priority of use. In the fourth the interval before reuse, delay. Below the table are the settings for the selected element in the table, as well as buttons for adding and removing list elements. If you suddenly want to change the order of the element in the list, just drag it with the mouse. Let's consider the available settings. Type. In this drop-down list, we choose what the bot will use to buff. A character's skill. An item. A pet skill. A pet's item. Or ingame buff. Ingame buff is needed on servers where there is an opportunity to get positive effects in the community board, Alt+B. More details on how to configure such a buff in the interface will be discussed at the end of the video. Items are used if the buff you need is applied not by a skill, but by an item, for example, a haste potion. And with the help of the pet skills, you can apply summon buffs on yourself, for example, the blessing of the seraphim. Name. After choosing the type, select the required skill, item, or ingame buff from this drop-down list. For ease of search, you can start entering the desired name. Please note that the bot has its own database, and the names may not be the same with those you see in the game. Interval is the minimum time that must elapse between attempts to apply the selected buff, i.e. the check of other conditions will be performed once in the number of seconds specified here. Delay before use. Here you can configure the time that the bot will wait after all the conditions are met, and before the buff is directly used, i.e. if a buff is expired, the bot won't immediately apply it back, but will wait for a few seconds, so as not to raise unnecessary suspicion. Moreover, the bot will once again check all the necessary conditions before using the buff. This function works only if you have enabled interval. For example, you have a bishop in your party that heals you at 60%. You can adjust ultimate defense in case the bishop gets distracted and your HP drops below 40%, but with a 5-second delay. Thus, when your HP drops below 40%, the bot will not immediately use ultimate defense, but wait another 5 seconds, then check the HP level again, and if it is still below 40%, ultimate defense will be used. Though if the bishop manages to heal you in these 5 seconds, the bot won't use ultimate defense. Combo. This option should be used when you need to rebuff several buffs at once. All buffs marked with this checkbox are separated in a different group and will be rebuffed only when the conditions for all elements are met simultaneously. If at least one of the combo buffs does not meet the conditions for use, the bot will not be rebuffed by them at all. This function is useful for dances and songs. For example, you can set up so that dances are buffed only when all dances expire, but at the same time, only after some specific songs. Remove buff. Using this function, you can configure the removal of positive effects that we do not need. If they reduce the stats we need. For example, Berserker Spirit. This function is similar to alt-clicking on a buff in the game. It is used in conjunction with the if-have buffs option. By default, the name of the selected effect will be written to the debuffs, but you can also add several buffs in the field below. All of them will be removed. Please note that when using this option, it does not matter at all which skill you had initially selected. I.e. if we want to remove the Berserker Spirit buff, but our character does not have such skill, we just select any skill, activate buff removal, and enter the name Berserker Spirit. With the help of this option, you can set up, for example, the removal of party ultimate defense by the tank as soon as it appears in character's buffs, so that the damage received by the party members won't redirect to our character. It is better to set up the party ultimate defense buff in the party heal buff tab. We have a separate video dedicated to it on our channel. Without target. If you enable this condition, the bot will not target itself or the pet before using the skill. It is advisable to have this option enabled for non-target skills, such as songs, dances, or warcrier buffs. In combat. If this option is enabled, the bot will use the selected buff, including during being in combat, i.e. while we are attacked by aggressive mobs, otherwise only when no one is attacking us. It is almost always necessary to disable this function for Alt+B buff because it is usually impossible to use it while being in combat. Due to this, Alt+B often causes problems at spots where mobs are constantly attacking the bot. In such cases, you need to run away from the spot to a safe place and wait so that you won't be in combat anymore, using a script. For example, the Hunter plugin can do this, a link to it will be in the description. Summon and pet. These options are responsible for ensuring that the selected buff does not work for character, but for summon and or pet, respectively. This means that all settings below will apply to summon creatures, not the character. Please note that when you activate one of these options, the first condition still controls the state of our character, and the second and third the state of the summon creature. When using a target buff on a summon or pet, do not forget to turn off the without target function if it is active. If no buffs or if have buffs. This is one of the most important settings. With its help, the bot checks the presence of the specified positive or negative effects on the character, as well as their remaining time and level. These options are opposite in meaning, so you can choose only one of them for a specific buff. Let's take a closer look at them. By choosing the if no buffs option, we need to indicate the name of the buff in the field below, the presence of which will be checked, and if it is absent on the character, the bot will use it. For ease of setting, you can double-click on the field to bring up a list of effects applied on character, as well as its skills. In addition to this, you can add a condition check for the remaining buff time or its level. For example, you can buff attack aura only if there is neither the aura itself, nor the buff with the same effects from Prophet or Warcrier. To make the rebuff happen a bit beforehand, set a condition less than 60 seconds for the remaining time. Also, we set the condition less than 2 for level, so that the aura will be buffed on top of buffs of others, if our effect is stronger. By choosing the if have buffs option, we need to indicate the name of the debuff in the field below, in the presence of which the bot will use the selected skill. So, for example, you can configure cleanse skill and enter a list of debuffs separated by semicolons in the field below. Or double-click to open a list of debuffs we are currently affected by, and select the ones you need among them. Please note that in case of debuffs, the conditions for the remaining time and level begin to work on the AND principle, not OR as it was in case of buffs. Let's consider an example. We have Purify skill, we want it to be used if we are affected by one of the listed debuffs, and only if the debuff time is more than 5 seconds. Also, with the help of these options, you can customize the use of auras. To do this, you need to add two items to the list. To enable if there is no buff, and to disable if there is a debuff. You can also specify additional conditions, for example, MP and the number of attacking mobs. Aura is configured in the self-buff tab, as opposed to the attack tab, will be used not only during the fight with mobs, which will make the behavior a little more realistic. Also, conditions for checking effects can be turned off altogether, but only if you have an interval configured and activated. This is suitable for skills that do not require checking for effects, such as summoning skills. Conditions. Here you can set up to 3 different conditions for the use of the selected skill, item or ingame buff. The type of condition is selected on the left, and on the right the value to be compared with. For different types of conditions, you need to enter different values here. For example, all sorts of conditions for HP, MP, CP, either percent or absolute values are indicated here. There are also conditions where you don't need to specify any values at all, for example, checks for root, stun, summon pets, etc. If you set up 2 or more conditions, they must be used simultaneously in order to use buffs. If you need a buff to be applied according to first condition or second, just make 2 buffs in the list and specify 1 condition for each. Be careful when you setting the conditions, they must not contradict each other, otherwise buffs will not be used at all. Use shot. If you need to save shots, this option allows you to flexibly adjust the conditions when and what shots should be used and when they shouldn't be used at all. For example, it can be adjusted so that shots are used only with skills that have long casting time, or only if we have low HP, or lots of mobs are attacking us. The main thing is not to forget to disable the option, turn on existing shots automatically on the miscellaneous tab. Priority. This scale is responsible for the sequence of using customized buffs. To change the priority, you just need to drag slider up or down. The higher slider, the higher the priority. In addition, the order of buffs is influenced by the order in which they appear in the table. I.e. if two buffs have the same priority, the one that comes first in the list will be used first. Let's now consider setting up a buff via Alt+B using the Adrenaline Bot interface. We select the ingame buff type and the name one of the proposed schemes, after which we click on the button H that became active. The ingame buff recording window will open. Press the record button. Then open the community board in the game, Alt+B, and sequentially select all the necessary dialogues to get the buff we need. After that, we return to the recording window and stop the record. Press the OK button. Set the buff interval to 10 seconds. And also activate the If No Buffs option. And add one or more buffs that we've received through the game menu. Do not forget to disable the in combat function. If it is enabled, otherwise, the bot will not leave combat while trying to apply buffs. It is worth noting that some servers have protection from such kind of settings, so if your bot doesn't want to buff, and every time you record dialogues, you see different lines, you need to use a script for a rebuff, for example, Hunter. Now you know everything about setting up self-buff in the Adrenaline Bot interface. If you want to know about the setting of other tabs, watch the video on our channel. And also subscribe and learn more about the capabilities of the Adrenaline Bot and scripts for it. You can buy a bot on our official website adrenalinebot.com. If you have any questions, feel free to contact our technical support in Discord.